Hi, I'm back. So we are coming to that place. I'd explained you all about the Chalcolithic age, how and what went happen, the sites and where all what was going on. So basically we have the information they were all rather hunting and fishing mostly, and their agriculture was in rice and their main food was rice and fish. Okay, now we see that in Mehrgarh in Pakistan is the earliest known farming and pastoral settlement in the Indian subcontinent. Perhaps it was here that humans first grew crops and tamed animals. We think that they grew crops and tamed. The earliest evidence of settlement here dates from 7000 BC to about 9000 years ago. Burnt grains and bones of animals have been found here. I had read that to you. Archaeologists have divided the Stone Age into several periods. This Stone Age, which is called actually the Copper Stone Age, has been divided into quite a few periods. What are those periods? Period 1 is from 7000 to 5500 BC. Okay, so that's round about 2500, I guess. Yes, no, 2500 years. So while wheat and barley were perhaps the main crops, as I have told you earlier, farmers kept cattle, sheep, goat bones, and of all these animals have been found at the site. Okay, the next part is we see the houses were built in mud structure, square, rectangular in shape. No pottery has been found. Burial sites, however, are many in number. The graves contain objects such as stone axes, ornaments of seashell, limestone, turquoise, lapis, lazuli, and sandstone, along with figures of women and animals. These are the objects that have been put into graves with the bodies, and they found the skeletons. I told you earlier what was happening during this time. So, what I told you, I can give it to you also. Class 6, you are old enough now. You have to make your notes also about prehistoric time, what was happening. So, I'll give you what I explained to you, like my notes which I was sharing with you of that part. I can give it to you in list, which will be much more easier for you. Like limitations of the Chalcolithic period, what were the burials type, the pottery types, that will be an extra knowledge for you, which you'll be having data with you. So it's not about only for class 6, your whole lifetime. If you talk about history to anybody and you start speaking like this, people will go awe and saying that what does this guy know? So that guy is serious and he knows his job, he or she knows his or her job very well. So I'll be very proud to know that, So from period 2, there are two periods. The first period was from 7000 to 5500. So now from 5500 to 4800, that's 5500 to 4800 BC. Okay, now what happened? Pottery, and there's a part 3 also, 4000 to 3500. So he's put two together. So pottery makes its appearance in period 2, as we said that wheel pottery which started coming in during those 10,000 years ago. But a lot of evidence of manufacturing activity has also been found. I mean, a lot of things have been made while archaeologists have been digging. They have seen that what we saw before, and now a lot of things are being made from different glazed faience beads were produced. Glazed means they were used burnt, and they had put something on it. When you burn, the glaze comes on it. So the terracotta figurines were detailed. It's very nicely made with. They had wrapped up clothes on it. You can make designs of clothes also on terracotta figures, and then they were put into fire to burn it up. Figurines of women had different hairstyles, ornaments, and were decorated with paint. Burial goods were limited only to ornaments during this period. I have told you earlier, they were only buried with chains and all. Few had bangles. Children were buried with beads and all that. So I had told you that. So you can match it. When I give you the same file, you can match it that there's nothing, something different out here. Then we were talking about the northeast. There were places in the northeast. Evidences of settlement have been found from the northeastern states also. What are the northeastern states? In the Garo Hills, many sites, places such as Selbagri, Thebrongiri, Mismagiri, and Rongram, Alagiri have yielded materials remains from the Stone Age. In Manipur, stone and bone tools have been also found. A stone axe dating back to this period has been found in Mizoram. That's also in the eastern states. It is quite big and thin. It is quite big and thin. Okay. So places such as Telmoria, Jirania, Mohanpur, Visalgarh and Agartala have yielded stone age remains also. Here instead of stone tools, here instead of stone fossils, wood which is locally available was used to make tools in this place. Okay. So this is what happened. In Daujali Hading, it's an important Neolithic site in Assam. Extensive digging at this site have yielded polished stone tools, ceramic kitchen items such as corn grinders, you know, for grinding corn, for doing the makai atta. So pestles and mortars, a large number of pots have also been found. All these finds suggest that people here were growing, storing grains and preparing food during this period time of the Copper Age. So we are done till here. So I have given you all information, so you have to read it yourself. To sum up, early humans became food producers during the New Stone Age. They also domesticated animals, began to make pottery and invented the wheel. Okay. So archaeological evidences of this age include pit houses, pottery, tools, human and animal buryings, burials and paintings. Early human lived in small groups. They were colonized, I told you. Bartering surplus food started early trade, you know, giving and taking. Human made tool of bone, both stone and copper during the Chalcolithic period. Mehrgarh in Pakistan and Northwest and Daujali Hading in the Northeast are important prehistoric sites. Numerous artifacts have been found here. Okay. I'm going to keep it till there. Don't worry. So I'm going to keep it till here and we'll go through this. And the next chapter we are going to start is the first cities. That's on chapter 4. So now what we are going to do is, now you are going to read the chapter yourself, go through it, and you will only do page 20, A and B. CD is my job. A and B is your job, CD is my job. Okay. So that's what you have to do, and we'll come to chapter 4 after that, and I'll see what I can do for chapter 4. It's going to take some time. By the time I guess school is going to open, and if school opens, oh my god, I'll be the happiest person on God's creation. So I'll be able to see all my guys, and I just like school. I like being in school. So anyways, so that's great, and we'll come to that, and we'll try to finish off today on Thursday. Enjoy your Friday, your weekend, but study on Friday. Saturday, Sunday, if you want to study, you can, or you can't, you don't want, but Saturday you can do some part of studies. So I don't force anything, you know, it's your life, your rules, you know. If you want to study, you study. If you don't, I cannot force it. I cannot put anything. I can't open your brain and put something inside there and again bolt it up and say, this is for Nishant. Open, Nishant take. Divyanshu, open your head, I'll put it in. And Pratik, open your head, my drummer boy, open. This is okay, this is special memory for you, put it in. And then after 2 days, you forget. So it's nothing like that. So anyways, take care of yourself, guys, and be home, be safe, and be clean, and enjoy yourself. Do not take tension. Everything will be in place. So everything has a reason for it. Whatever happens has a good reason. So take it, be positive, optimistic in life, and respect your parents. Okay. And love them as much as you can and respect them. They are the only thing in your life. That's the only important and the most precious valuable part of you is your parents. So please do respect them and take care of them also. You're old enough to take care. That doesn't mean you have to work. There are other ways of taking care of your parents as well. So they'll be also a bit happy, and this is the time to be together. So take care, be good, and do whatever you want after you do your studies. Bye bye, and see you on Tuesday. Okay. God bless. Take care.